Hey, greetings, everyone. Welcome back. Today, I've got a special guest, Guillaume Rondan of Move to Asia. How are you doing, Guillaume?
Very good, Dean, and you?
I'm good, thank you. Today, we're going to talk about electronics, high tech, or AI transformation in Vietnam. So a lot of times we think of Vietnam as a low-cost manufacturer, overtaking China and things like that, but lots of interesting developments are happening in Vietnam today. Guillaume, what's happening in Vietnam?
There's been some recent news lately. The CEO of NVIDIA just visited Vietnam, signed a partnership to build up his facilities. They actually make a significant investment just to acquire one of the quite well-known Vietnamese companies in that sector, which is Vinbrain. So it's a subsidiary of Vingroup, one of the largest Vietnamese companies. So that's just one news over others that are pushing Vietnam in the direction of getting more and more traction and recognition as an electronic manufacturing hub.
Okay, so NVIDIA, I've heard of it before. Is it like an AI or high tech kind of a company from Taiwan, isn't it?
They're going to basically do the microchips. So, you know, it's going to be like everything that you're going to be plugging on the PCB, so on the printed circuit board. So there is a lot of technical term out there. So far, until now, most of the components are made in Taiwan, for instance. And recently, with the current developments, the trade tensions between the US and China, Taiwan, then you know you have a lot of companies that are seeking diversification. And Vietnam now appear on the map as a potential player to not necessarily replace Taiwan, but to be also being able to assemble as well as all the testing and then the packaging line. So Vietnam can be one of the players that can provide that as a manufacturing hub.
I think that's so smart because you look at nearby China, they've moved along from manufacturing in the 20, 30 years ago to doing textiles, furniture, all of that, toys. And then now they're moving into AI, high tech, chip production, electric vehicles. So like a higher tier of manufacturing. And so now it looks like Vietnam is starting to take on that too. What else do you know about maybe some other developments happening in Vietnam, maybe electronics or any other high tech developments?
Yeah, so I can share one of our latest clients that actually visited Vietnam 2 weeks ago. They're a group of US scientists back with some consultants that came to Vietnam to understand about the current landscape. And they came with a project of doing a punching bag. We basically is a bag, so full of foam. And inside, they want to equip it with an electronic device that will be plugged with sensors, you know, so basically to capture the movement of the bags and to make everything in Vietnam. So there will be a rubber aspect and then the foam and then sourcing also the electronic. And through their journey, we brought them to different factories. And for the electronic aspect, there are a lot of different players in Vietnam right now. You have the ones that are only focusing on the conception and development, so they can basically bring your idea to life. And they have also the facility that is able to do sampling and then also go to mass production.
Okay. You know, last time I was living in Vietnam a few years ago, I would see information technology, some of the companies that we're doing some tech support. Can you talk about that, what's happening there or what you've come across?
Yeah, definitely. So I think on the IT aspect, math is very important at school. So you have talented Vietnamese that will fit very well in the IT sector. And for probably 10, 15 years, there is actually a group of companies that are setting up offices and then the tech hub in Vietnam to subcontract or to support foreign entities. So let's say a company in France will be having 10% of their effective and their team in France just to support the clients. And all the designers, the tech people, the developers, sometimes even the data centers are maintained from Vietnam. So you can really allocate and have a team that is across different countries. And Vietnam is one of the countries where you have that. People may know about the Philippines to have the call center hub, and Vietnam will be the one for IT development and IT maintenance.
Yeah, you bring up a good point. You know, I'm from Minnesota, and I knew a guy, an engineer. He started BTM Global. Maybe it's 20 years now, but his company helps support companies that develop their software and set that up for point of sale. So large companies, maybe a Target, or other types of merchandising place, they set up the Oracle system. And so he started, I think, in Minneapolis, and then he opened an outsourcing company in Vietnam. So now he has two locations, you know, one in Minnesota and one in Vietnam. And I think each location has over 100 employees. So something very similar to what you mentioned, using Vietnam, the IT, the outsourcing, that labor and doing it there. So very, very impressive.
Just thinking about outsourcing, probably now with the local talents, the fresh graduates can have very good English. The new generation will be equipped with also English skills so that can also be suitable for call centers. But not only, you can also have probably like marketers, designers, maybe video editors. You can probably also look for those talents in Vietnam that can support the venture that you are pushing overseas. And just considering the labor cost differences, there are also good opportunities into allocating or building a team or even helping other companies to build their team in Vietnam to support offshore businesses.
And then when I was living in Vietnam, I stayed in a place called Da Nang, which is the beachside city. This is about 2018, so a few years ago. And then I also started to hear about them building up like an IT zone or a section. Do you know anything about that?
There's been also recent news a couple of months ago about FPT, which is the largest technology company in Vietnam with offices across the world, but this is a Vietnamese company. And they are aiming to build the largest AI data centers and research hub in Vietnam, and they position it in Da Nang. I think it's an investment of around $200 million. And have something branded new to attract foreign direct investments. So helping more companies to also establish or support IT-related topics. And it's one of the best cities to consider if you are planning to benchmark Ho Chi Minh City versus Hanoi or versus Da Nang. For tech-related projects, Da Nang is a very good city and very good hub to consider.
And then earlier I had mentioned about China and electric vehicles. I know in America that they're building up electric vehicles from the major car manufacturers. And I know there's a high import tariff, 100% under the Biden administration. So to keep out the Chinese electric vehicles. And I know Europe, similar. I believe there's politicians, some policies, they're trying to keep electric vehicles out. And then in the last few years, I think most people don't know that Vietnam, VinFast is the company, they're making electric vehicles. So I don't know if you know much about what's happening in that sector.
For VinFast is the leading EV manufacturer in Vietnam that are right now exporting to a lot of foreign markets. I know they have cars delivered to the US. I think they also opened a couple of months ago an office in France. So they want to also expand in the region. And then they're the leading one, private company. But of course, they have full support from the government. In terms of the type of art, I'm not sure that they are right now matching and at the level of all the other foreign cars manufacturers. And I guess some part of the vehicles, such as the batteries, for instance, are still imported from overseas. But there is this dynamics of players that are also plugged to those EVs vehicles. And I have a very good friend of mine. He's working for a startup right now, and they are distributing a device that is plugged on vehicles and that is fully equipped with all the components, with SIM that can geolocalize and access to 4Gs in Vietnam and provide hardware and software that they are offering. So it's still a startup, so it's still at the early stage, but it shows that there are more and more local players as well that are equipping and that are making products in the EV and in the automobile industry in Vietnam.
It looks like Vietnam is kind of moving in a direction towards AI, high tech, and all of that. Now, what do you think are the pros and cons in terms of what the future holds for Vietnam and with the Trump administration? How do you think things will develop?
That's a very good question, Vin. I think just because of the Trump administration going to protect US-based manufacturers, they may push tariff for all foreign goods. So it can be goods imported from China, but not only. It can also have a domino effect, and everything that is coming outside of US will be impacted. And considering making Vietnam good, I think the country can still be positioned well in the sense that Vietnam is very close to China. So each time you need to import raw materials, you have direct access. And Vietnam is also quite close to Taiwan. So it can be a good alternative country to have a part of your supply chain. But it doesn't mean that at the moment, all the facilities and factories are equipped with the appropriate technology, R&D, and then just human resources. So there may be a gap. If you are used to manufacture in China or in another foreign market, don't expect that you can just copy-paste what you are having at the moment and find the same in Vietnam. You may have higher prices, you may have MOQs that will be either higher or lower, it's gonna really depend on your industry. And then you probably will need to also take time to invest and to also train probably the local people that you'll be working with in Vietnam. So probably plan a trip in the country, meet up potential partners, also be part of this project of working with Vietnamese people.
Yeah, you bring up a good point, because what I foresee is a lot of growing pains. I think the government's making very strategic investments, focusing on IT, AI, technology of the future. But like you mentioned, there's going to be a lot of disconnect, for example, like the labor, the training, the education, you know, that's kind of still lagging in some aspects. And even the infrastructure, all of that, you know, Vietnam is transitioning. They don't have a lot of things in place, but it makes sense in terms of where the economy is going, in terms of higher types of incomes and jobs and development, all of that all makes sense. I mean, look at China, look at Taiwan, look at all these other neighboring countries. So a really good point.
Mentioning some names, you have now Samsung, you have now LG that are already having part of their operation in Vietnam just assembling line, right? So they will just import different materials from neighboring countries, and Vietnam will be the place that they're going to assemble, test it, and package it. So it still means that big players are bullish for Vietnam and are thinking that the country, there will be more and more improvements, and for them it makes sense. So I think it really depends on the scale that you are having right now in terms of your plan to manufacture goods overseas. And if you think Vietnam can be a potential market, you can always go through, you know, due diligence, going with a tour, so really spending time in country to really understand about the pros and cons and what lacks at the moment, and see if it's good enough to invest, or if you should go to a more mature market, for instance, China or somewhere else.
All right. So very exciting times for Vietnam in terms of adopting these future technologies and moving maybe in some ways away from the low-cost manufacturing.
Yeah.
All right, Guillaume. Thanks a lot. Really appreciate it.
Yeah, you're welcome, Vin. Talk soon. Bye. And I'ma get it right, dead on sight like